The Duchess of Cambridge looked pretty in a floral patterned dress as she arrived to unveil a playground paradise inspired by her Chelsea Flower Show garden today. Kate, 37, formally opened the Back to Nature garden at RHS Wesley in Surrey, the centerpiece of which is a giant wooden treehouse for youngsters to enjoy. The mother of three made the most of the September sunshine and opted for a pale blue dress by designer Emilia Wickstead, featuring belt detail which cinched her in at the waist. Keeping her makeup minimal, the natural beauty paired her outfit with beige wedges and wore her glossy brown locks loose. She was joined by celebrity chef Mary Berry, an RHS ambassador, who similarly opted for a flowery dress, which she paired with bright pink heels and a matching cardigan. The unlikely duo looked in high spirits as they were photographed hitching a ride on a tractor trailer, alongside several other children, to a fete-style festival that marked the garden's launch. Kate's co-created gardens were previously exhibited at the Chelsea Flower Show in the Hampton Court Palace Garden Festival, with the aim of highlighting how time outdoors can enrich a child's early development. The final Back to Nature space includes elements like the hollow log from Chelsea and the wildflower meadow and rolling hill showcased at Hampton Court. New features include two connected treehouses and slides, which encourage families and friends to have fun together in the natural environment. The garden, which was designed by a team from the Royal Horticultural Society with input from Davis White Landscape Architects, is larger and even more child-friendly than before, with a sandpit, water feature and a set of swings and a hut made to look like a hedgehog. Kate was taken on a tour by Matthew Pottage, curator of RHS Wesley, and planted a weeping blue cedar tree to formally mark its opening. Local children taking part in an RHS garden project enjoyed the features of the open space, bouncing on small trampolines embedded in the ground and crawling through a tunnel, while six youngsters were crammed into the seat of a very large swing. The Duchess could not help smiling when she saw the group happily swinging and quizzed them about her garden. She said about a water feature, "I like the idea of water on a hot day. Take your shoes off and have a splash." The Duchess of Cambridge could not resist sharing a fun moment with a young mother and her daughter during the visit to her latest family-friendly garden. Kate put her hands on 15-month-old Matilda's head, danced with the youngster and playfully rubbed her hair as she relaxed with families invited to the launch. Two boys, brothers Oren and Bushy Touchem, aged 10 and 8, gave Kate some sweets for her son Prince George, 6. Bushy also gave the Duchess a homemade card for the little prince. Kate said, "George will love those. It's so sweet of you. Have you had a fun time today?" "Thank you so much." Speaking to attendees at the festival, Kate admitted she was not as green-fingered as many, but highlighted the importance of the cause. The Duchess said, "I am not as green-fingered as many of you here, but I was passionate about creating a garden that inspired children and adults alike to get back to nature and reap the positive mental and physical health benefits that it can bring. More recently, however, I have learned that these often safe and supportive environments can also bring significant benefits to the cognitive, social and emotional development of our children too. The experiences we gain during our earliest years influence who we become as people. As a parent, I have learned just how important it is to foster our children's development, in all areas, not just physical, as soon as they are born. We build the blocks, the foundations, for future success and happiness later in their lives. These relationships, however, stretch far beyond the crucial one that a parent or carer has with its child. There is a well-known proverb, that it takes a village to raise a child. Everyone here represents an integral part of that very village. By coming together, having fun, learning and experiencing new things, we can all impart lifelong benefits on our children. Sue Biggs, RHS Director General, said, "We are grateful to the Duchess for the incredible impact that this Back to Nature collaboration has had. There is no doubt that this project, through her passion and vision, has highlighted that access to natural environments and green spaces isn't just nice to have, it's vital to have. This is something that the RHS also strongly believes in and will continue to champion through our Greening Great Britain campaign and charitable work." The Duchess of Cambridge decided to help create a special Chelsea Show garden as part of her early years project, which is exploring how childhood experiences have a direct link with the issues some face as adults, such as addiction and social exclusion. Kate believes that spending time outdoors plays a pivotal role in children's future health and happiness, building foundations that last through childhood and over a lifetime, and is keen to find ways to encourage this. She got all her children, Prince George, 6, Princess Charlotte, 4, and Prince Louis, 1, involved in the project, collecting sticks and fir cones, and the three of them came down to Chelsea in May with their father, Prince William, 37, to help unveil it. Speaking to teachers who visited the site with their pupils, Kate was heard to say, "It's really important the kids start to understand nature, and care for it, so they can protect it as well. With Instagram everything is so visual. It's nice to sit and feel." The garden was redesigned for the Hampton Court Flower Show and now takes up a permanent home at Wisley. Kate hasn't been involved in the designing of the new play garden but has taken a keen interest in its creation. A Kensington Palace spokesman said, "As part of her long-standing work on early years, the Duchess of Cambridge believes that spending time outdoors plays a pivotal role in children's future health and happiness, building foundations that last through childhood and over a lifetime." Through her Back to Nature gardens, which were displayed earlier this year at the RHS Chelsea Flower Show and the Hampton Court Palace Garden Festival, Her Royal Highness has aimed to highlight how spending time outdoors can enrich a child's early development by providing an environment that encourages active exploration and the opportunity to form and strengthen positive relationships. She has spent much of the last 8 years meeting charities and organizations who work every day to make our families and communities stronger. To mark the opening of the garden, RHS Wisley held a Back to Nature festival to celebrate the value of communities to our well-being. Kate invited schoolchildren, charities and organizations who have helped her work in the early years field to enjoy the fun. The Duchess toured the festival, which had a village fete feel, watching toddlers trying their luck at a coconut shy, while nearby was a cake stall covered with sweet treats. She stopped to chat to another family, crouching down to speak to Dylan Corbin, aged 3. Who had a tiger painted on his face. His mother Katie Vinton, 32, from Woking, said, "Kate asked, 'Are you a tiger?' And Dylan replied, 'No, it's just face paint.'"